How does the power of the resurrection impact a person's life far after Easter? We're going to take a look at that during this program. Be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. How does the power of the resurrection impact a person's life the days following Easter? How does it give a person the strength to continue on? I want to talk to a veteran at this time, a veteran that never thought that he'd end up homeless, but there he was, on the streets without any place at all to go. Tell us your name.
My name is Dennis Simpson.
And Dennis, how did the power of the resurrection give you strength to continue on in spite of the obstacles?
I kept faith and hope. And I wasn't gonna let myself just totally give up. That's why I reached out to you and your ministry, which is, did a wonderful job in helping me and to be the type of person I am now, getting back on the road to being a part of society as a taxpayer instead of being a nuisance on the street.
Well, I don't see you as a nuisance on the street. I see you as someone that Jesus identified with when he said, "Foxes have holes and birds have nests, but he, the Son of Man, came into our midst." Yes, but he, the Son of Man, had nowhere to lay his head. And so we reach out to those that are homeless and in need. And as the power of the resurrection comes to live within the very depths of our being, comes a part of our very DNA, we are then compelled to reach out to those that society would try to cast to the side, that society would consider a nuisance. Because experiencing the resurrection of power of Jesus Christ changes everything. Have you been growing in the knowledge of that power while you've been here?
Yes, sir. Yes, I have. I really have that positive attitude, and my whole outlook on life and God has changed due to your program. And I just, my hats off to you. I salute you for your effort. Well, for you, I will be wandering another lost soul.
The resurrection changes everything. Go back to that Saturday between the day when Jesus died on the cross, which they refer to as Good Friday, and Easter morning. The despair, the confusion, the frustration among the disciples, among those that believed him to reform things on the site and on the spot. But yet he died on a cross. It looked like the cause was totally gone, totally finished, but something totally revolutionized it in a matter of hours. That Easter morning, Christ came forth from the grave. And as time passed, over 500 people saw him after he rose from the dead. Numerous appearances took place. And lives that were frequently filled with fear and worry and unbelief were transformed on the spot. And he promised, "I would never leave you alone, but I'll send my comforter, the Holy Spirit." Dallas Holmes has done actually a classical song referring to all this, that "I'll Rise Again," the promise that Jesus made. And it's a promise that he makes to us right now in the midst of our trials, our tribulations, whatever problems you may be facing, whatever I may be facing, when things seem so hopeless and so despairing. The resurrection message is not only something we celebrate on Easter Sunday, but all year long here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. And we invite you to experience it also, the reality of Christ's words, "I will rise again." You can call if you desire special prayer, have special need, 314-436-2424. It's 436-2424. But I want you to know that there is hope because Christ is risen.
Drive the nails in my hands, laugh at me where I stand. Go ahead and say it isn't me. The day will come when you see. 'Cause I'll rise again. There's no power on earth can tie me down. Yes, I'll rise again. death can't keep me in the ground. Go ahead and mark my name. My love for you is still the same. Go ahead and bury me, but very soon I will be free, 'cause I'll rise again. There's no power on earth can tie me down. Yes, I'll death can't keep me in the ground.
Father, into thine hands I commend my spirit.
Is this not the third day? He is risen. Go, tell his disciples and Peter that he will meet them in Galilee, just as he said.
When the resurrection power of Jesus Christ touches your life, it transforms it. You're filled with a holy boldness and a determination to do what God has called you to do. I'm talking to an activist right now in Belleville, Illinois, Lee Griffin. And Lee, how has the resurrection propelled you to decisive action?
Well, I know that it's a great power that's working in me, and it keeps me motivated to try to help people a little less fortunate, such as what you're doing here. So whenever that Macedonian call out and I come over and help assist you, you're doing such remarkable work over there. I'm just glad to be at your disposal.
Well, Lee, you really went head-to-head with St. Clair County, and you really went to battle over there and encountered some resistance. How does your faith help you to keep on doing that?
Well, because I got faith in God, and I have faith in myself. And I know when your heart is hit, you can't quit, especially when you know what you're doing is right. And it's for the betterment of other people. You just got to keep on plugging.
Tell us the organization you're with right now, what y'all are doing.
Yes, I got an organization over here started called the Citizen for Social and Economic Progress.
Okay.
And what we do, we try to help people that's coming in out of the prison system that don't have nowhere to go. And we try to help people get back on their feet. And we're just trying to work in the community and make a better place for everybody.
And that's what you're doing right now?
Absolutely.
Working to bring about that kind of justice for people all
yes.
over. How can individuals contact you?
Well, I have a number what I can be contacted. We got an organization, again, called the Citizens for Social and Economic
yes.
Progress. And we have an available phone number
uh-huh.
if anybody want to get involved. Plus, we have a website
yes.
where people can communicate with us. And I'll be glad to make the number available
yeah,
for anybody.
Yeah, what is that number right
The
now?
Number is area code 618-365-3137. And you have a lot of people in prison now who is innocent.
Yeah.
And when you talk, when you speak to power and they don't listen, a lot of innocent people be in prison and that don't serve the community or does justice. And when these people come back out, they're bitter. So we're trying to reach out and come up with preventive measures to stop people from
going
to prison.
You were once part of that prison system, weren't
you? I was for 16 years for crime I didn't commit. But with God's glory, I made it back through the eye of that needle.
How did you keep from getting bitter in the middle of all that?
Because I exercised a lot of prayer, and
yeah.
I had a great family. And I was undaunting. I heard no so much from the courts that no sound like a strong maybe to me.
Yeah.
And I just kept on fighting, kept on praying.
And that made all the difference in the world?
Absolutely.
So at the cross, you find the power, you find the strength, the ability, and the determination to keep on moving on.
Yes, and when you put all those elements together, you can be a powerful force to be reckoned with, even inside a penological system.
Now, you indicated to me also that you need to get a shelter over in Illinois.
Absolutely. And, you know, because we burden you so much with all our people from Belleville,
yeah, yeah.
having no place to go. And I've been talking to the power structures there saying,
yes.
we got to do something to alleviate this homeless problem. Because our people shouldn't have to come all the way from Illinois all the way over here
yeah.
to Missouri. So I'm a strong advocate of trying to work with anybody who will work with us to try to get a homeless shelter in St. Clair County.
We're working with a church in Venice, Illinois to get one going, but that's still a distance from Belleville. We've got to get something going in Belleville. I've
Absolutely.
Been saying that for years.
Yes, you have. And I agree, even when you tried to get the old Turner building.
Yes.
But if we keep on fighting, I think something's going to come through for us.
We just can't find a building and move in it.
Absolutely.
And that takes determination, prayer, and willpower. But God is in control.
Yes.
And at the cross, we discover that power. Yes. Good Friday, our folks often go out and carry the cross on that day, but we got to carry it all year long. And that means carrying it into the trenches and speak truth to power, doesn't it?
Absolutely. And we want to keep you in our prayers and let you know we're fighting with you on that side and anything we can do. And we appreciate you coming out to our rallies, bringing
yes,
your people out.
You.
We were able to feed them and break bread with them.
Yes,
and we're
going
to be having
thank
other
you.
Demonstrations
okay.
and bringing things out, letting people know we need a homeless shelter.
God
so
bless
we know
you.
If we call on you, if you can make it, you will come.
Yes.
And we welcome you.
Well, we thank you. And again, what was that phone number?
Area code 618-365-3137. And our Facebook page, all you got to do is type in
yes.
Citizens for Social and Economic Progress. And I'll give you all the information.
All right. When you go to the cross of Christ and allow His transforming power take place in your life, and let the message of the resurrection spring forth, you experience His grace and the power of the Holy Spirit to move forth in the midst of injustices and proclaim truth to power. Proclaim the truth that there is hope. Christ is risen. Yes, at the cross we find that power.
At the cross, where I place all the might, and the burdens of my heart go away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all day. At the cross, where I place all the might, and the burdens of my heart go away. It was there by faith.
The guy you saw carrying that cross around at the cross, the song, is Ray Redlick, and I have with me at this time his wife, Judy Redlick. And Judy has experienced a transformation through the power of the Holy Spirit, encountered the power of the resurrection. And Judy is blind. She came to us in 1975 at the New Life Evangelistic Center. She'd been a folk singer. She was out there. And the power of the resurrection just zapped you, turned you upside down and inside out, didn't it, Judy?
Well, it really did. And I had no idea what God had for my life. I had graduated from Missouri Valley College, have a BS degree in journalism and psychology. And I just didn't know what God was going to do with me. And I went out and was a folk singer for like 9 months and came back and heard about them starting to build KNLC. Well, it wasn't known as KNLC then, but a Christian television station. And I had done my internship with KPLR TV Channel 11 when I was a senior in college. And I just kind of learned just to the tip of the iceberg about TV. And I kind of fell in love with it. So when I heard about them starting this Christian TV station, I came down and talked to Larry and Penny Rice and met them and just wondered, did God have something for me to do here?
Judy, we thank God for the years that you were here working with us at the New Life Evangelistic Center and getting Channel 24 on the air. How many years were you here?
Oh, let's see. I came in 1975 and in July of 2007. Was when God started me on another journey.
You went to Joni and Friends, is that right?
Joni and Friends, uh-huh.
Okay, and what do you do at Joni and Friends now?
Well, I help churches start disability ministries. Uh-huh. I run our Missouri office, actually, and we help churches start disability ministries, and if they have a disability ministry, help them get to a new level. And we also collect wheelchairs, walkers, canes, and crutches, and send teams to Mexico from the U.S. Wow. to partner with churches in Mexico to help persons with disability with the gift of mobility, but really, we help them find Jesus Christ as their personal Savior.
Now, I heard you speak earlier. You talked about packages, you know, and how God works through people regardless of what the package may be. Go into a little more detail about that.
You know, sometimes God wraps us in packages we could never imagine that we're in. And I think He specializes in the impossible, and that's why He does that. Like, for instance, a blind person having a TV show for 20 years. You know, I can't see the camera. I can't see where the little arrow's pointing. I don't know when to shut up, and I don't know when to start. And God, I think, has a sense of humor putting a blind person on TV for that time with a talk show. And He might have the same thing for some of you all that are in your line of work or what you're doing for Jesus.
Is that what you tell people that do have various disabilities, that it's not a handicap, you're not handicapped, you may have a disability, but you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you?
That's exactly right. You know, in John 9, verse 3, it says, why was this man born blind? And it wasn't because of his parents' sin, but it was because God wants to be glorified. So here's the ticket. You ask God to show you, how do you do this thing, Lord? And it looks impossible with a disability. But with God's help, He can show you the insight on how to be an overcomer in that thing and do it through His power. And then who gets the glory? Not us, but Jesus.
And that's where it is, Jesus, the power of the resurrection. Judy, I'm sure that over the years, you mentioned doing a TV show, but there's many things. You play the piano, you play the guitar, you play the banjo, the harmonica, all these instruments, okay? But Judy, I'm sure there's times when you felt the task before you was overwhelming. How does the power of the resurrection help you to do that, perform that task?
Well, knowing that Jesus Christ took more hits than we could ever take makes it all worthwhile. You know, we think we suffer a lot, and we do suffer, but it teaches us what it's like to be in the valley, and it helps us appreciate more when we level out or have something, a mountaintop experience happen to us. But I think, you know, the fact that Jesus Christ took more than any of us could ever take makes all the difference, because we know that He's not going to give us more than we could bear.
Is there a particular Bible verse that has taken real meaning in your life all these years?
Well, John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, and whoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. And that's for each one of us, including people with disabilities, including people who are homeless, and people who feel lost and alone and forgotten.
So that's the message that you speak. That's the message that you share, that there is hope. And God loves us in the middle of all of our need.
That's right.
Tell me some stories. I know for years you did a blind ministry here at the New Life Evangelistic uh-huh. Center, and you reached out in many different ways. And the new ministry that you're in right now, you are working with churches. You said you're gathering wheelchairs, take them to other countries. You're doing different things. What do you try to get these churches to do besides perhaps get you wheelchairs and other items?
Well, we want churches to change their attitudes toward people who are marginalized, and especially people who have disabilities. In fact, you know, when you think of the statistic that only 10% of people affected by disability go to a local church, what's wrong with that picture? The attitudes, you know, you can either have a SpongeBob attitude where you're willing to grow, or you could have an attitude like a brick wall, never wanting to change. And that 10% will never grow unless churches reach out of their comfort zone and want to know how to work with people affected by disabilities, how to help them through their loneliness, through their discouragement, help them to feel a feeling of trust and a belonging, a feeling of belonging. And that's why I do what I do. I help churches start disability ministry so they can change their attitudes and so people affected by disability can feel welcome and at home and encouraged and not just spoon-fed, but then share the gospel with, they accept Christ, and then they are challenged to go out and win others for Jesus.
For many years, you worked here at the New Life Evangelistic Center now with Joni and friends, but also you were a wife, Ray Redlick. We know Ray's my assistant here at New Life Evangelistic Center. You're a mother. You've raised two children all those years, and you were blind. Some might ask you, how'd you do it?
Oh, that's been a big challenge, especially, uh-huh. You know, having a boy and a girl, and we used to live in this duplex,
uh-huh.
and we took homeless people
right.
on the other side. And so what we did is we had doors on this side, and then they'd go run down the hall, and then a door here and run down the hall. You know what my son did? He would rip and run down this hall, through this door, up this hall, and I would have to run and catch him. And then when I was running fast enough to catch him, you know what he did? He'd shinny up the wall, and he'd put his hands on this side and his feet on this side and run across the ceiling like that. So he tried everything to get
to hide from you.
To hide from me so I couldn't spank him. So anyway, but my kids have turned out, our kids have turned out great, and God has done some great things in their lives. And that's another thing that you just have to pray for. And any of you parents that have challenges in raising your children, you got to pray for God to give you the wisdom and the insight. And if you keep Jesus first and you look for him to give you the answers that you need, he will, and you will have kids that are growing up for Jesus.
And David, he's in college now?
David will actually, uh-huh. he is finished with his schooling, but he graduates. He walks down the aisle on May 16th.
Okay.
So we're pretty excited about
What's
that.
What's he getting a degree in?
Well, he's getting his degree in business and marketing, and he has a full-time position with the company that he internship-shipped with.
Oh, so and Melody, what's she doing?
Melody is an interior designer. She's uh-huh. a project manager for a commercial interior design company, and her husband, Jeremiah, they've been married 5 years, and he is a firefighter, his dream job, with the Lima Fire Department.
Okay, and you're with Joni and Friends, okay.
I run the Missouri office of Joni and Friends, and Joni Erickson Tata is the founder of the international ministry, Joni and Friends, and so I run one of the field offices.
All right, and again, if churches would like to start a ministry there, how could they contact you?
314-773-5664.
Okay, once they contact you, what happens then?
Well, then what we do is we kind of line up a consultation with them to find out where they are now and what kind of vision they have for people affected by disabilities. And, you know, it doesn't cost a lot of money to do it because a lot of it's the attitude change. And once an attitude changes, then all sorts of possibilities.
Can you tell us about a few of the churches you've done this with?
Well, Bonham Presbyterian is one of our lead churches. Twin Oaks Presbyterian.
What do they do at Bonham?
Oh, Bonham has classes on Sunday mornings for kids, and they have a Wednesday night time when all the kids with special needs eat dinner together,
yeah.
And then they go join their families for the regular church service or different classes. And we have African American Calvary Temple or Calvary Missionary uh-huh. Baptist Church on Martin Luther King Drive. They have a disability ministry. And we have churches all over
now,
the
now
area.
Now, church, let me ask you this. Let's look at the mechanics. And uh-huh. A church may have one blind person, two deaf people in there, three people in wheelchairs. How do they do something for all these different groups with different disabilities?
Well, that's where we offer them training on a quarterly basis uh-huh. as well. Like just recently, we had a training on how to have a sensory Sunday school class. And
what's a sensory Sunday school?
That is where kids that have sensory needs, how to work with those kids. You know, like kids that have a real problem with strobe lights, or kids that have a problem with loud music.
Yeah.
And learning ways to work with those children.
All right, I'm talking with Judy Redlick, and Judy, give them that phone number again if they'd like to start
all
such
right.
a ministry.
And we'd love to invite you to our training meetings. We'd love to have mm-hmm. a free consultation with you, and it's 314-773-5664 is my office at Johnny and Friends, Greater St. Louis.
All right, as we wrap this up, Judy, maybe people need just hear from you about why is it so important that we fight for New Life Evangelistic Center and continue to take in those that are hurting and homeless? What would you say?
Well, over the years, I could tell you countless people whose lives have been changed. Mm-hmm. People that I've worked with
yeah.
throughout the years. And if New Life Evangelistic Center weren't here for those people, or wouldn't be here for people in generations to come, as we see the days, the end times grow darker, and the homelessness problem increase, where are they going to go? And they got to go somewhere. And it's just like taking a plastic bag and filling it up and filling it up. Pretty soon it's going to pop.
Right.
So what happens is those homeless people are not having a place to stay at New Life Evangelistic Center. What's going to happen to them? Who knows? And we're only going to see more crime, more strife, more challenge, because people are going to feel purposeless, they're going to feel homeless, they're going to feel left behind, and they're just going to not know what to do with themselves.
And we're determined to continue to fight the good fight.
That's
yes,
right.
We have many people with disabilities that come to us. We have blind people, deaf people, people in wheelchairs, and so many veterans and women, children. Your prayers, your gifts right now make a big difference in that ongoing battle for the rights of people to have a place to sleep at night. For further information, go to www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. If you'd like to volunteer, give us a call, 314-881-3218. That's 881-3218. And how we thank God for those of you that are praying and sharing your much-needed tax-deductible gifts now with the New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. Thank you for caring, sharing, and letting the power of the resurrection work through your life.